Siobhan Stagg and Joseph Middleton were to have performed two of my favourite song cycles this lunchtime, Messiaen's Poème pour Me and Strauss's Für letzte Lieder, his four last songs. But lockdown doesn't imply shutdown, so here, as a poor substitute, are some thoughts on these two works. Though song constitutes a mere fraction of Messiaen's output, there are three great cycles for voice and piano, he was confident of his ability to write for the human voice, as he explained to Claude Samuel in 1986. I quote, "I believe that I am a good composer of songs, because everything that I have written to be sung, I have sung myself. I am equally aware of the problems with diction, the phonetic value of vowels and consonants, the importance of breathing, the right place to breathe, and the different registers of the voice." Messiaen's Poème pour Me date from 1936, 2 years after Webern's Opus 25, and were first performed in Paris in April 1937 by Marcel Bernlet, with the composer himself at the piano. Me is the nickname he gave to Claire Delbos, the violinist he had just married, and the dedicatee of these 9 songs. The poems by Messiaen himself betray the influence of the great surrealist poet Pierre Reverdy and quote passages from the Bible, but they remain distinctly individual. They celebrate the joining of man and woman in the sight of God, but also give expression to the doubts that assail them. Although the words are sung by the husband, they are, like almost all of Messiaen's works for voice and piano, written for soprano. He orchestrated them in 1937 for triple woodwind, 4 horns, 3 trumpets and tuba, percussion and divided strings, and the first performance of this version was given in 1946, sung once again by Marcel Bernlet. The works divided into 2 sections. Book 1 opens with Action de Grâce, Thanksgiving, a poem in which man thanks God for the gifts of nature and a woman's love. The song ends fittingly with 7 radiantly melismatic Alleluias. Paysage, landscape, presents me as a figure in an idyllic landscape. Et la voilà verte et bleue. La maison, the house, refers obliquely to the heavenly life that the couple will eventually enjoy, devoid of all worries. Not so épouvante, terror, a breathless song in which the fiancé is assailed by the thought of losing his love, both divine and terrestrial. Messiaen's vision of hell is expressed in music that is wildly chromatic, with the singer vocalising with stylized demonic laughter, ha and ho. If the songs in Book 1 describe the preparations for marriage, Book 2 opens with L'épouse, the wife, after the couple's wedding. The song celebrates the sacramental marriage of the man and the woman with a sensuous lyricism and ends with a meditation of the mystical marriage of Christ with the Church. Ta voix, your voice, praises the beauty of his wife's voice. Such optimism is continued in Deux Guerriers, Two Warriors, which presents the two lovers as companions on the journey through life's vicissitudes. The penultimate song is called Le Collier, the necklace being a symbol for the man's arms wound about the woman in an embrace. The cycle ends, as it had begun, with a prayer, prière exaucée, fulfilled prayer. And, as all doubts are cast aside, the music ends in joyous celebration. La joie est revenue. Much of the complex rhythmic writing of Poème pour Me frees itself from the tyranny of the bar line and occasionally poses formidable difficulties for singer and pianist, especially in Action de Grâce and Épouvante from the first set, which, however, contains 2 songs of great intimacy, Paysage and La Maison. The second set of five songs also juxtaposes comparative simplicity, L'Épouse, Ta Voix, and the wonderful Le Collier, with songs of impressive grandeur, Les Deux Guerriers, and the concluding Prière Exaucée, with its extraordinary evocation of bells. Late in 1946, Richard Strauss came across a poem by Joseph von Eichendorff, Im Abendrot, which ended, Ist das, etwa, der Tod? A line that Strauss changed to, Ist dies etwa der Tod? The line struck a chord, an effulgent E-flat major chord, in the octogenarian composer, and by May 1948, Im Abendrot was finished. But it was only when an admirer sent him a volume of poems by Hermann Hesse, who had just been awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature and was therefore topical, that he set about selecting additional poems to go with Im Abendrot. The idea of the Fürletzte Lieder, however, would only be created posthumously by the publisher Ernst Roth. The first in that set was Frühling, Spring, a poem written about the turn of the century, an ecstatic paean to the beauties of spring, which Strauss completed on July 13. He now turned his attention to Beim Schlafen gehen, that Hesse had written some 15 years after Frühling. Hesse's romantic view of life has vanished. Having witnessed the horrors of the First World War and the collapse of his wife's mind, he was now undergoing a grave emotional crisis. The poem tells of the soul's weariness and how, when the day is done, it wishes to take wing and soar up into the magical circles of night. This is nothing less than a death wish, symbolized in Strauss's setting by the long interlude for solo violin. The way the voice enters, at the last descending phrase of the violin solo, calls to mind a similar way in which the voice enters in Morgen, in mid-sentence, as it were. In both cases, it's as though the singer were too moved to interfere with such enchantment. Beim Schlafen gehen was finished in August. In September, Strauss turned his attention to the aptly called September. It describes the way in which summer closes its wearied eyes. Langsam tut die großen, müd gewordenen Augen zu. Within a year, Strauss too would be dead. And this is the most autumnal of all the four last songs. And just as in his last opera, Capriccio, so too, here, the horn plays an important part. Strauss never heard his Fürletzte Lieder live. The first performance was given by Kirsten Flagstad and the Philharmonia Orchestra under Furtwängler in the Royal Albert Hall on the 22nd of May, 1950.
Près de mon œil, une Thank you. tire pas, ne froisse pas, ne déchire pas. Tes lambeaux sanglants te suivraient dans les ténèbres, comme une âme seule, triangulée.
Thank you.
Des deux, nous voici en avant. Comme des guerrières ardées de fer. Ton œil et mon œil parmi les statues qui marchent. En avant, guerrière sacramentale, tendez joyeusement vos boucliers. Lancez vers le ciel les flèches du divin Mandarin. Vous parviendrez au port de la ville. libro.